My wellness is indefinable. All definitions of what I am are actually definitions of sickness. Any definition at all of what we are is actually a definition of sickness. It's a form of sickness. These bodies that we have are really forms of sickness. We're rehearsing for death. This is a simulation of time existence. These bodies are our way of rehearsing for death. So if you see a body, you say this is one form of rehearsing for death. This is one, this is a definition of death. We're defining death. Now, of course, death can never happen. So all we can do when we're being spirit, when we want to die, all we can do is rehearse for dying. We can't actually die, but we can rehearse for it. And so that is what we're doing. We're rehearsing. So all these bodies, again, a definition is sickness. We're defining sickness. What we are cannot be defined. As soon as we're trying to define what we are literally defining sickness, rehearsing for death. Now, wellness cannot be defined. So what we are prepping for is wellness. We're prepping for timelessness, wellness. We're preparing for wellness. Wellness cannot be defined. It is indefinable. It is beyond any definition. So we don't, well, in our preparation, we don't want to try and represent it through artwork. We don't want to try to label it through a book of explaining what wellness is as far as defining wellness. We can point to it, which is what we're doing here. We're saying it's beyond what we can point to. It's beyond any place, any definition, space and time, etc. Cannot be defined or expressed or represented or symbolized in any way. All symbols are symbols of sickness. All representations are representations of sickness. No matter how beautiful they may appear, they're still representation of sickness, and therefore are still a rehearsal for death. Doesn't matter how beautiful a painting is, how beautiful a picture is, how beautiful a song is, all that stuff is still sickness, or a representation, a rehearsal for death. And since we can't die, what can we do? We rehearse, and this rehearsal is called sickness. Now that the so-called dying of the body is just part of the sickness, it's just part of the sickness. And the rehearsal goes on. Now, our identity is both nothing and everything, abiding in nothing and everything. Therefore, it does not have any definition to it. We are not anything distinct. We are both are and we aren't. Each and every particular, we both are and we aren't, because we're everything and nothing. We cannot be defined by anything. We cannot be defined by anything. And yet that's what we're trying to do, because we're trying to die so we can become something else. Very simple and obvious if you see it this way. If you see that spirit wants to be prime creator, which means spirit would have to change what it is. It's not prime creator right now. It's that which is prime created, but not the origin. It's not the origin of itself. So it wants to be the origin of itself. Therefore, it has to believe it can change what it is. And since it is an indivisible whole, and all reality is an indivisible whole, it would have to die to what it is. Meaning a complete and total final disappearance from what it is, with no more trace of what it now was. And then it would have to be resurrected into a new spirit, and it would then claim that it's its own origin. It's the original prime creator. So this cannot happen. So spirit has to simply, all spirit can do is rehearse for this to happen. That's all spirit can do, is to rehearse for it to happen. So all of this stuff we're engaged in is just a rehearsal for what will never happen. So we're rehearsing death, we're rehearsing sickness, we're rehearsing dying. And literally all of this, our lives, all stuff, is nothing but a form of sickness. It's all sickness. There's no wellness here at all, because wellness cannot be defined. It cannot be expressed or symbolized or represented, labeled, named, or anything. Now, we can prepare for wellness. We can rehearse for wellness. That is possible. That is what we have to do. But in doing so, we must steer clear of trying to label it, define it, represent it, symbolize it, depict it. We have to practice not doing those things, because wellness is beyond any of that. And any of that is seeing ourselves as sick. If we see ourselves as other than what we are, we're rehearsing for our own death, and that is what we call sickness. Sickness is the rehearsing for our own death. We feel sick. We feel sick. Everybody here actually feels sick all the time. There's just varying degrees of it. So we say, well, I'm not quite as sick as they are. But this entire situation is a situation of sickness. Preparing, prepping, rehearsing for death. And all of existence will always simply be a rehearsal for death. That's all it will ever be. It will never be anything more than that. So if you're tired of that, the only avenue out is to give a different purpose to mind and say, I want to prepare for timelessness. I want to prepare for wellness. I want to prepare to drop sickness, drop definition of what I am, definition of reality. Drop that. Drop the effort to be prime creator. That's the only avenue out. Otherwise, you will remain sick. All you're doing is changing definitions. So sickness will seem to go in all sorts of different ways, kaleidoscopic ways of sickness, all sorts of different varieties of sickness, of types of rehearsal. It will come in so many different angles to you. That's all you get. That's all you get. Along with all the defenses of denial and justifications and rationalizations and judgmentalness and conflict and competition and intrigue and drama and all this stuff of sickness, all of that, that's what you get. And that, as long as we want to be prime creator, all we'll get is sickness. That's it. So obviously, in seeing that, you say, hey, this is no fun at all. No fun at all. Now, the fourth dimension, which has taken over this planet, has a hierarchy system based on how willing you are to try and define yourself. In other words, how willing are you to be sick? And if you're not willing to define yourself to be sick, you end up have the lowest status in fourth dimension. You literally are nothing here. So I certainly don't want that. I don't want to be in a society where I have no value at all. That's certainly not right. So I'm highly motivated to get out of that, get out of this situation. Because as it is now, I have extremely low status here because I'm not unwilling to play the definitional game. And thus, fourth dimensional automatically relegates you to the lowest rungs where you'll be picking up roadkill and trash and the sudras, dealing with all the net cleaning out toilets and stuff like that. That's it. If you're lucky, but really you end up being executed. So why stay in such a situation? It doesn't make any sense at all. Certainly someone like this would be looking for a better situation where those who are prepping for wellness have value, are seen as valuable, are seen as very welcome and valuable presence, as a motivational, helpful presence. That's all. That's all. People want to feel useful. That's all. We don't need to be praised or anything, but just a feeling that, hey, people say, hey, you know what? They're useful. They're helpful. So I appreciate that. Just a sense of appreciation for the helpfulness of it. Otherwise, what's the use? What's the use? So, again, I'm super motivated at this time. Prep for wellness. Now, when we start to prep for wellness, we will have feelings will begin to arise, which are like we say, hey, that's not a sick feeling. I don't, that's different. It doesn't seem to be sick. There doesn't seem to be sickness to it. Fine, great. But don't try and then label it and define it and put it in a box and package it. Don't try to package it. Just let it be. Just let it be. The mistake would be to get it get a glimpse of this, these feelings, and the symbols that arise along with them, and then try to say, ah, I can make a beautiful painting or a mandala or something spiritual to help people. They could hang it in their living rooms and look at that and say, oh, I'm inspired or something like that. That's a big mistake. Because then you're just throwing a monkey wrench into the entire thing. And you will end up getting hooked into a lifestyle that is not wellness at all. Avoid that like the plague. Sure, there might be some who do that and they'll get famous and rich from it, but they won't get enlightened. And they won't inspire others to enlightenment. What they'll inspire is saying, hey, I can have something pretty along with my sickness, defined with my definition of what I am. My rehearsal for dying, it's being supported by the angels, by God. This is all wonderful, you know. No matter how you try to spiritualize it, it doesn't work. It doesn't work. Because even the most spiritual definitions of what we are sickness. And it's easy to get trapped into that. Very easy to get trapped in that. And people think, I've defined what I am as a spiritual being, as love and light and all this stuff. And so that's it. No, that is still rehearsal for dying, for death. It is still sickness. And it's an insidious type of sickness. Have to go beyond definitions of spiritual, of beautiful, of inspired, of all this stuff, everything. Forget about definitions. And you will find something that transcends definitions. You won't even want to define it. As long as you want to define your experience will be something that seems to lend itself to definition. Even if you think it's a beautiful definition. But when you are willing to step into releasing your efforts to represent something, then you will experience something that transcends representation. And that then is touching on enlightenment. We should have learned our lessons by now. Of all this spirituality, we realize that's not it. It's not it. As Jesus says, let go of everything. Let go of all definitions, all concepts, no matter how lofty, all definitions, no matter how thick, let go of all that. Go beyond all of that. Only in this way will you then begin to get a sense, begin to prepare for our true identity, prepare for wellness. What we are is so far beyond any representation that it is folly to make representations. Truly a folly. It is so limiting. No matter how beautiful those representations are, the most beautiful music, the most beautiful paintings and dance and sculpture and creative activities are still utterly and pathetically limiting, and they're just forms of sickness. They really are forms of sickness. And what is sickness but a rehearsal for our death? And why rehearsing for our own death? Because we want to change what we are and become prime creator. That is why. Our creativity is so far beyond representational creativity that forget about trying to be creative in this world. I say, you know, I'm creative, I'm making things, forget it. That is a rehearsal for death. What we are in reality is beyond anything we can imagine, is beyond anything we can represent. So much so that it's utter folly to think that we can represent it, or label it, or define it. And again, indeed, all such efforts are actually part of our rehearsal to die to what we are. Because it's not accepting what we are. We're saying, oh no, we can represent reality. Here's a painting, here's a mandala, here's some beautiful representation of reality. No, it's not. It's not anything at all but a form of sickness. Let's be very careful about this. By saying that reality can be represented, or we get this reminder in this in representation, and we think, ah, this is it. No, it's not. It's not. It is not. That is still rehearsing for our death. Because the experience of prepping for wellness is something beyond all of this art. And it's folly to think that representing it in any way is anything other than a rehearsal for death. Because the undefinedness is lost no matter how we try to represent it. We can say, oh, we're representing this in a very abstract way. Still, same thing. So really, in prepping for wellness, one goes beyond this compulsion to try and represent what one is experiencing. Now one can certainly say, well, I am experiencing what is beyond definition. That is fine. For instance, like these videos, I can say, okay, I'm having this breakthrough. Narrate just the facts of this is what is taking place. And then how are the reactions there? But I try to steer clear of, you know, what does it feel like? What am I feeling? And trying to represent it into some tangible, you know, symbolic form. Try to steer clear of that. And this is the preparation. So paradoxically, you see those who are stepping into wellness, their surroundings may be very barren and like a monastery, you know, there doesn't seem to be any creativity going on there. Nobody's trying to make anything. And the music may be very simple. No one's trying to be creative. And you may think with horror, like, oh my gosh, what a horribly empty life that is. But just the opposite is in meditation, they are experiencing this incredibly sublime states, which is prepping for wellness. And they know that it's a big mistake to try and define it. As soon as one tries to define it, the sublimity of it disappears. It's no longer sublime. It's mundane. They're not trying to bring heaven down to earth. That is the mistake. Trying to bring heaven to earth is the mistake. Don't try to do that. There's no reason to do that. Trying to do that is simply trying to turn reality into death. Heaven is heaven. Earth is earth. Why try to combine the two? It is the most ridiculous thing. It is literally trying to rehearse for your death. Trying to say, I can change reality. Because earth is nothing but an effort to change reality. That's what it is. It's a rehearsal. A rehearsal, a simulation of time, a simulation of sickness, of death, and an effort to change reality. So don't try to bring heaven to earth at all. Leave it undefined. Heaven is not definable. You cannot represent it. You cannot symbolize it. So give up these efforts. You cannot be captured in poetry or any way. And the less demand there is to capture it, the easier it is to go to actually experience it. The goal is to experience it, not to capture it. You cannot catch a reality. It's like trying to capture a complete spaciousness, perfect spaciousness. How do you capture it? You cannot capture it. So it's our desire to capture what we are. It's the desire to die to what we are. So the worst thing you can say is possible. To say that puts impossible demands on everyone. Exactly the opposite of what we need to do. What we need to do is free one another and say, I'm not asking you to establish heaven on earth at all. Just imagine how freeing that would be to everybody. To give up that demand that others serve your desire to have heaven here on earth. Give that demand up for others. What a very great liberating. If people ask, what is love? That is love. That is love. Is give up your demand that others have to slave to try and represent heaven here on earth. Because you're really demanding their death. You're demanding that they die to reinforce your own commitment to your rehearsal to die. Your definition of death. So you're really committing, trying to get everybody to keep recommitting to sickness. So we continue our 180 degree turnaround here. The turnaround is essential because we've gotten so much bad advice throughout the years. So much bad advice from very so-called spiritual sources who were trying to have it both ways. They weren't ready, quite ready to step into the undefined and accept that. So they say, well, we can bring the undefined to the defined and define it here on this world. Let's make a definition of it. We can have a beautiful heavenly place here. And so it's a mixed message, a very mixed message. And so we've gotten so many mixed messages that we need to clear all that up. Clear it up. Go forward. And start prepping for wellness. Start prepping for wellness. It starts with saying, hey, I don't need you to try and bring heaven to earth for me at all. No way. Just the opposite. You don't have to do anything in that regard. You don't have to try and beautify this world. You don't have to make beautiful music or art or landscaping. You don't have to do anything at all for me. And that's true compassion right there. Because then they say, then I can experience this prepping for wellness without feeling a demand to then be inspired by it and then rush out and try to, beautify someone else's garden or our walls, our life, they're try to do clever decorations and things. I don't need to, I can stay in this condition. I can stay in it and continue to experience it, which then preps me for ultimately stepping into the undefined, which is true wellness, which is identity. So that is the way it's supposed to go. We say, I don't have to compose a song and play it for people and spend my time that way. No, I can remain in this wonderful, wonderful prepping. That is true love. That is true compassion. That is the way we need to go. We need to forsake the mixed messages. Absolutely. I don't care who is given the mixed messages and what kind of authority they seem to have. It doesn't matter. A mixed message is a mixed message, period. So let's set each other free of these impossible demands that we represent reality, an impossible demand. That is not prepping. That is not preparation. We need to be in a preparing mode, not a representational mode. And people have trouble mixing these two up. Preparing means to not represent. If you're representing, you're not working on preparation. It's exclusive. It's one or the other. You can't have it both ways. So go beyond all the fame and the fortune that come from being a very clever representationist. I've been there, done that, believe me. It's something that I never wish I'd never done. Big mistake, huge mistake, caused massive suffering for myself. Sure, I got fame and fortune, but drastic mistake. Don't forget about fame and fortune and being a clever representationist, which the world will applaud, of course, because you're sending the wrong message out to everybody, saying like, hey, you can be happy with this. This is good enough for you. Or it's close to being good enough for you. No, it's not even remotely. No representation is even remotely good enough for you. I don't care what it is. I don't care. The most sophisticated stuff that's ever been made in this world isn't even remotely close, doesn't even touch upon our prep. Our prep has a different quality to it. The feeling has a different quality to it. It has this beyond representation. You don't even think about wanting to represent it. It's nonsense to represent it. I don't care how famous the person was, how renowned their artwork was or representation was. It doesn't matter. It's just a form of sickness. So let us forsake it. It doesn't matter if somebody else is going to let them. If someone wants to be clever, let them be clever. Let them make $1 trillion. It doesn't matter. Because I would rather experience even a little bit of prepping for wellness, mild, gentle prepping for wellness, than have all the money and power in the world, all the fame and the money and the power and access to all that. I'd rather have just a little gentle prepping for wellness. And so would you, and so would everybody, so would everybody. So this is the example that we need to set. All right, onward we go, onward we go.